Thank you. Thank you. It is our great pleasure to be here this evening. My name is Eric Richards, and this is the Whitney Center Jazz Orchestra. Thank you. First of all, happy International Jazz Day, April 30th, 2022. We're planning on celebrating that with you. Let's give it up for International Jazz Day. We have a little bit of housekeeping. Okay, so in the spirit of International Jazz Day, we're going to open up with a piece with an international flavor. It's a piece that is set in the style of a Brazilian samba and a particular kind of samba called samba batucada, which is like a hybrid of a samba and a march. And this was written for the Greeley Jazz Festival in 2008, and their big performance center is set at the intersection of 10th and 7th Street in Greeley, Colorado. So I called it 7th Street Samba. So this is going to start with a little percussion groove. You can imagine a group of samba dancers heading down the street. I think it's a percussion groove of about 16 measures in length. Inside joke for the band. And then we're going to hit it. And on this, you'll get to hear from Mark Israel on trumpet and Dr. Zach Paris on drums. Here's 7th Street Samba. Thank you. Thank you. Mark Israel on flugelhorn. Zach Paris on drums. Yes. All right. So this is a concert taking place at an academic institution, so we're going to have a brief little discussion about the next tune. So in music composition, there's a technique known as the contrafact. And who knows what a contrafact is? Raise your hand if you heard. Okay, very good. So if you don't know what that is, that's a fancy academic term for a new melody composed on a set of existing chord changes, existing harmonies. This technique has been around for hundreds of years, and it is really popular among jazz musicians, largely because it allows us to avoid paying copyright fees. So. But we're going to play a tune that actually, this next arrangement starts out with a contrafact. There is a new melody composed on a set of existing chord changes to the great old standard, There Is No Greater Love. And in so many groups, bass instruments don't get a lot, the bass register just does not get a lot of love. You know, so we have two fantastic musicians taking care of the bass register of our ensemble. And I thought this would be a great opportunity to show them a little love and let you hear what great musicians they are. So on this arrangement of There Is No Greater Love, on bass we're going to feature Michael Steele. And on, yeah, okay, give it up for Michael. And on bass trombone, John Gower Jr. Here, yes. Or as we affectionately refer to him, the Low John. So, we're going to continue with There Is No Greater Love. Thank you. Thank you so much. Let's give it up one more time. Michael Still, John Gower Jr. All right, this is another Wyoming premiere of a piece. I wrote this piece in 1980 for a dear friend of ours, Mike Tamaro. I wrote it for his senior recital. And then, what would it be? I guess 33 years later, something like that. 2013, I revised it for another dear friend, a music educator who is retiring, Dan Nakura. And this is a tune that combines elements of gospel music and funk. And we have just the musician to play this for you. From Worland, Wyoming, we're going to feature Willie Wright on a piece titled Looking Back.
Thank you.
One more time for Willie Wright. Yes, all right. No big band concert, in my opinion, is complete without paying homage to the great Count Basie. Here is one of his signature tunes, arranged by the great Sammy Nestico, Shiny Stockings. Thank you, Shiny Stockings. Tom Amend in the role of Count Basie. And on lead trumpet, taking us through that piece, give it up for Brian Bull. This is it's always great when we can get together. We've come to the point where we really enjoy hanging with each other as human beings, and we enjoy making music with each other and then playing it for our lovely Sheridan audience. It's always a blessing. However, this time that we've gotten together, we have to acknowledge it's a rather bittersweet moment because about 2 weeks ago, we lost a charter member of our group, a stalwart musician and educator, Douglas Bull, who after a brave and courageous battle of many years passed. And so we thought it would be appropriate to pay tribute to him on tonight's concert. And so I've asked our lead trumpet player, Doug's good friend and colleague, John Harbaugh, to say a few words.
Well, excuse me while I use my notes here, but I have the honor to speak tonight, and I'm very pleased to do that. I met Doug in 1995. So at the Yellowstone Jazz Camp, Neil Hansen, the rector, said he found a new trumpet player for the section. That faculty band rehearsed all week and then we played at the final concert. At that time, I thought to find a professional trumpet player with years of top-tier playing experience would be similar to finding a trumpet player of that caliber hiding behind every palm tree in this state. I don't think there's too many palm trees here. Wow, was I surprised. Doug was one of the finest musicians I ever had the opportunity to work with. He had done it all. Recording sessions, playing behind greats like Frank Sinatra, Sammy Davis Jr., Bob Hope, and he also worked as a classical soloist. He played 6 presidential inaugural balls. I mean, I could go on and on and on about his playing career. In addition to this, he was an outstanding educator. On top of that, he was so much fun to hang out with. Great stories, great sense of humor. Most people don't know this, but one of his hidden talents was lat stop malfunctions. He had so much energy in his body that if he held a laptop, he could fry the electronics. I think some of the folks in black suits wanted to have him go to work for them. So it really goes without saying that the music community will continue to deeply miss Doug. One thing that keeps my spirits high, that as a Christian, I'll see him again. And I would be selfish to wish him back for all the joys he's now experienced in heaven. Doug was a great colleague, a great friend.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Well, continuing on with International Jazz Day themed music, we're now going to play a calypso for you. And you heard me mention our dear friend and my musical brother, Mike Tamaro. He wrote a really cool calypso titled Allegria. And on this, for the first time tonight, we're going to hear from Nick Simons on trombone and Donicio Trujillo on alto saxophone. Here's Mike Tamaro's Allegria.
Thank you.
All right, well, this first half of the concert just seemed to fly by. We've come to the last selection on the first half, and then we're going to take a 15-minute intermission, and then we'll come back and play a little bit for you and introduce our wonderful vocal soloist for the evening, Alicia Dupre. So we're going to end with one more great Count Basie arrangement. Musicians call this a flag waver because it's generally at kind of a fast tempo, and this is another Sammy Nestico treatment of the good old Sweet Georgia Brown. We hope you enjoy it. Thank you, the Whitney Center Jazz Orchestra. See you in 15 minutes. All right, thank you very much. Welcome to the second half of our concert. We're excited to play this for you. We're going to open up with a really fairly epic big band chart written by a wonderful tenor saxophonist and composer-arranger. It's a composition called Simone. And we thought it would be fun and interesting to feature an instrument on this work that you don't hear frequently with a big band. It's called the EWI. EWI, the electronic wind instrument. And we're very fortunate in that one of our tenor saxophonists is a wonderful EWI player. And so we're going to feature him on this piece, as well as Tom Amend on piano, Gino Hernandez on EWI. Here is Frank Foster's Simone. Simone, Frank Foster, Gino Hernandez, Iwi, Tom Amend, piano, and leading us through there on lead trumpet, John Harbaugh. All right, so here's that moment that we know many of you are here to experience. We are so fortunate to have this musician with us. She's a violinist, songwriter, singer, active in many different styles, commercial, country, crossover, and jazz. And so without any further ado, would you please join me in welcoming Sheridan's own Alicia Dupre.
Goes walking, and when she passes, each one she passes goes ah. When she walks, she's like a samba that swings so cool, and sways so gently. Then when she passes, each one she passes goes ah. Oh, but I watch her so sadly. Walking, and while she passes a smile, she doesn't see. So sadly, how can I tell her I love her? Yes, I would give my heart gladly, but it's day when she walks by the sea. She looks straight ahead, not at me. Tall and tan and young and lovely, the girl from Ipanema goes walking, and when she passes, a smile she doesn't see. She doesn't see as she walks by the sea. She doesn't see. She doesn't see me.
Well, welcome. So nice to see you all. I'm glad for the little ones that show up. So thanks for joining us, everyone, big and small. On this next song, I'll be making some sounds. And sometimes when vocalists make sounds, it's called soloing. And mostly I'm looking to elicit the sound of an instrument. So as I start to put consonants with vowels and sing all over, that's really what we're getting at, is to really act like another instrument. So with that, I also just want to tell a very quick story, which is the fact that we have a very talented writer on our team here and has done a tremendous amount of work for this concert. And I heard him tell someone else that he came out of his own practice room and said to his wife, "Who wrote this stuff?" And that person is Dr. Eric Richards. Thank you so much for all your writing. All right, here's "Someday My Prince Will Come." someone to call my own, and I'll know him the moment we meet. For my heart will be skipping a beat. Someone to say and do all the things. Someday, someday, when my dreams come true, the nearness of you. It's just an image. And I feel so close to me. May I take a moment to say thank you to those who are hosting us in this hall. Jake and Charlie, thank you for running sound tonight. There are a lot of people also in the booth, so Colin and those of you who I don't know, thank you also for all of your work. We're live streaming tonight. And thank you to Debbie Isaacson and the college for hosting us. So one more. Here we go. Thank you so much. This tune is an old Bob Dylan tune, and I first heard it because a friend of mine, Patty Toby, turned me on to this artist named Madeline Peru. So thank you for enhancing my music career by sharing your music with me and for hosting us this weekend. So this is for her. I've seen love go by my door. It's never been this close before. Never been so easy or so slow. Been shooting in the dark too long. When something's not right, it's wrong. You're gonna make me lonesome when you go. Dragging clouds so high above. I've only known careless lies. It's always hit me from below. This time around it's more correct. Right on target, so direct. You're gonna make me lonesome when you go. Purple clover, queen and lace. A crimson hair across your face. You can make me cry if you don't know. Can't remember what I'm thinking of. You might be spoiling me too much love. You're gonna make me lonesome when you go. Flowers on the hillside blooming crazily. Crickets talking back and forth in rhyme. Blue river running slow and lazily. Oh, I could stay with you forever. Never realize the time. Situations have ended sad. Relationships have all been bad. Mine have been like Verlaine and Rambo Road. can't compare. There's no way I can pay to this affair. You're gonna make me lonesome when you go. You're gonna make me wonder what I'm doing, standing far behind without you. You're gonna make me wonder what I'm saying. Gonna make me give myself a good talking to. I look for you in old Honolulu, San Francisco, and Ashtabula. Gonna have to leave you now. I know that I'll see you in the sky. In the tall grass, in the ones I love. You're gonna make me lonesome when you go. 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 Long funny ears, he kicks up at anything he hears.
His back is brawny and his brain is weak. He's just plain stupid with the summer sleep.
But if that sort of life is what you wish, you may grow up to be a mule. Oh, would you like to swing on a star? Can a moonbeam home in a jar and be better off than you are? Or would you rather be a pig? Big is an animal with dirt on his face. His shoes are a terrible disgrace.
He has no family.
But if you don't care a feather or a fig, you might grow up to be a pig. Oh, would you like to swing on a star? Carry moonbeams home in a jar and be better off than you are? Or would you rather be a fish? Fish won't do anything but swim in a brook. He can't write his name or read a book. But if that sort of life is what you wish, you might grow up to be a fish. Oh, would you like to swing on a star? Carry on moonbeams home in a jar and be better off than you are. Would you we'll be right back.
it up for Alicia Vince. Mark Israel on that funky trumpet. All right, we're going to introduce the members of the band since we're not using a printed program. And we'll just introduce them from your left to our right. On saxophones, director of bands at Cheyenne High School, master of the iwi. Give it up for Gino Hernandez. Up-and-coming wonderful saxophonist, alum of the great saxophone studio at the University of Wyoming, Denisio Trio. It's rare to find a collegiate administrator who can play the blues, who is so funky. And he is a funky, he's a funky saxophonist. He's doing a great job on lead alto, and he's also the Associate Dean of Arts at the University of Washington, University of Wyoming. Give it up for Dr. Scott Turpin. Another one of our wonderful music educators in Wyoming and from Moreland. Would you give it up again for Willie Wright? And joining us all the way from Billings, Montana, in addition to being a wonderful baritone saxophonist, she's an exquisite clarinetist. Give it up for Maddie Johnson. And now we come to the engine, the instrument that is truly the engine, the center of the band, the trombone section. Yeah, you know that's right. When composers want to portray the voice of God in compositions, they don't use a saxophone. They use a trombone. All right, my main man from Cheyenne, a wonderful music educator, jazz trombonist, flutist, singer, Nick Simons. One of the finest young trombonists and educators I have ever had the pleasure to work with, director of bands at Sheridan Junior High School. Give it up for Aaron Schanzenbach. World-class bass trombonist, tenor trombonist, singer, Renaissance man, originally from Billings, now participating in the music scene in Denver. Please give it up for Mr. John Gower Jr. All right. Now be careful how you handle these guys, the trumpet section. They don't need a lot of love because they already, you know, they already have a lot of internal affirmation. But we're going to, right? Am I right? Am I right? Right? Okay. All right. You heard him several times tonight. Retired jazz trumpet soloist from the U.S. Air Force Falconers, Mark Israel. Our lead trumpet, assistant director of the Whitney Center Jazz Orchestra, and professor of trumpet at Central Washington University. Give it up for John Harbaugh. And we are so blessed and pleased that he can join us tonight. He is a wonderful trumpet player, emerging leader in the Army Bands program. You're going to be hearing from this young man. Give it up for Brian Bull. And what can be said about these next two musicians, fantastic teachers, combined with Aaron, I call them the Knutson Brass Institute, conductor emeritus of the band program here at Sheridan College, wonderful trumpet player and conductor, Dr. Dave Knutson. You guys all know her, you love her. She built a fantastic program at Sheridan High School and is a wonderful trumpet player. I'm so pleased to have her on the band. Give her some love, Miss Diane Knutson. Yeah, all right. Now this group really is the engine of the band. We cannot do anything without a great rhythm section, and we are so fortunate to have one. So, on piano. We met, many of us met this young man when he was a mere wisp of a lad at the Yellowstone Jazz Camp. He was about this tall, and now he's developed into a world-class jazz pianist in Denver. Give it up for Tom Amend. We are fortunate in this region to have so many excellent musicians. I mean, these musicians could be playing anywhere, and we are blessed that they have chosen Wyoming and Montana and Colorado, the region, to bless our music scene. This next gentleman is a great example of that. Just an excellent guitarist, and we're lucky to have him on the band. From Bozeman, Montana, Craig Hall. Also from Bozeman, Montana, wonderful bass. Can I tell him about how long you've been playing the bass? All right. This just is amazing to me. We have a fantastic bassist. Wouldn't you agree? Didn't you think he did a fantastic job tonight? He's been playing the bass 4 years. So, students, go home and practice. That just shows you what can be done. And he's also a licensed practicing music therapist. I think that's pretty cool. From Bozeman, Montana, give it up for Michael Steele. All right. And driving the whole thing from the drum set, I met him when he was a student at the University of Nebraska. And he really blew my mind with his with the way that he played. When I directed the band, he was the only student that would ever argue with me when I made an observation. I said, I like the cut of his jib. So I knew that he had a bright future, and he is doing fantastic work as the director of bands at Northwest College. Give it up for Dr. Zach Paris. The Whitney Center Jazz Orchestra, ladies and gentlemen. Beautiful. All right, we have had a full semester of concerts, of groups coming in externally, our own groups here at Sheridan College, and we still have a couple of concerts left to take us to the end of the semester. There we go. So this Tuesday, directed by our Dr. Robert Cerny, Director of Choral Activities here, we have our Sheridan College choirs in concert. We'll get to hear the chamber choir, and we will get to hear the collegiate chorale. It's going to be a wonderful evening of music, and that will be free. So it's this Tuesday at 7 o'clock. Then the final concert for our bands and jazz program, we have a lot of fun with this. I think this is our 7th annual Pops concert. So that will be on Thursday, May 12th at 7 o'clock. We will be doing it indoors, and we'll try to make it a lot. We're going to try to pretend like it's an outdoor park concert, but it's a lot of fun, low stress, a lot of fun. I hope you'll come to both of these concerts and enjoy it. All right, we have one more piece on the program, and this is a piece I was asked to write while the COVID lockdown was going on, and so many groups were doing those virtual mosaic kind of videos. And so my friends in Nebraska said they wanted to still have a Nebraska All-State Jazz Band, but it was going to be all virtual, and they were going to carefully bring students into a recording studio and record parts, and then put it all together into one of those mosaic videos. And they wanted it to be a piece that would allow for lots of improvisation so that they could have lots of soloists within this piece. And so that's what it turned out to be. And of course, since it was written in 2020, I called it Hindsight. There, this is where you say, all right, very good. So we're going to use this to feature several soloists in the band. We'll feature Willie once again on tenor saxophone, Nick on trombone. You'll get to hear, you've heard him on lead trumpet all night, but you'll get to hear him as an improviser, John Harbaugh. We will get to hear Craig again on guitar and Zach on drums. So once again, thank you for being such a wonderful audience. Here's our final selection for the evening, Hindsight. the Whitney Center Jazz Orchestra. Thank you very much. Would you like to hear one more? All right. To be honest, you were going to hear one more anyway, but all right. Okay. How many boomers do we have in the audience? That's what I'm talking about. Me too. Well, I think some of the coolest music that was written during the boomer era was music written for cartoons, right? So we, again, our dear friend Mike Tamaro wrote this wonderfully swinging arrangement of the theme from Spider-Man. And we're going to close the evening with that. I think you're going to enjoy it.